إن الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. أبو بوك بلوغ المرام وإن الحديث 250 part 2. You have seen part 1. Now inshallah we go through part 2. Part 1 was the hadith to say in your last tashahhud, اللهم إنا أعوذ بك من عذاب جهنم ومن عذاب النار. اللهم نعوذ بك من عذاب جهنم ومن عذاب القبر ومن فتنة المحيا والممات ومن شر فتنة المسيح الدجال. And then we talk about some of the biography of Tawus. Now Aisha, صحيح مسلم أن عائشة رضي الله عنها زوج النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أخبرته أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كان يدعو في الصلاة. Prophet used to recite in his salah. This is another version. اللهم أعوذ بك من عذاب القبر. That's number one. وأعوذ بك من فتنة المسيح الدجال. وأعوذ بك من فتنة المحيا والممات. وأعوذ بك من المأثم والمغرم. مأثم is what causes you sin to commit a sin. What leads you to commit a sin. والمغرم is to be in debt. To be in debt. قالت فقال له قائل. Someone said to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. That's her. She said to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. Yeah. ما أكثر ما تستعيد من المغرم. Yeah. You are a lot of times. You ask, you seek Allah's refuge from the debt. Why? That is a very problem. It affects your iman. Affects your iman. Ya Rasulullah. Faqala. In the rajula, the person, idha gharima, yeah. When he falls in the debt, and the people need the money, isn't it? Haddatha fakadaba. He tells and he lies. وَوَعَدَ فَأَغْلَفَ and he promise and he breaks his promise. I'll bring you tomorrow. I'm coming now. Yes. And he's lying. Why? Because he's in the problem of he can't face the debtors. He can't face them. So he's lying. So the lying and breaking of a promise is coming from debt. Be free of the debt when you die. A man, yeah. There was 2 dinars, 2 pounds, whatever, yeah, on him. He borrowed it. And when he died, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, yes, is there any debt on him? They say, yes, Prophet of Allah. He stopped praying on him. Because Salah of the Prophet, yeah, will take a person to paradise, isn't it? But they have debt, so I'm not praying on him. And one of the commanders, Muqtad, he said, O Prophet of Allah, I'm taking over that debt. It's on my neck. I'm paying it, not on him. So Prophet prayed on him. And now you see in the life, a lot of Muslims, they take a loan or debt, whatever, and they prepare not to pay at all. They plan it not to pay it. Carelessness. And they want Allah to accept the salah. When you want to pay the debt and you're unable to pay it, and you're unable to pay that debt, and you die, Prophet will bring on you. What about if you plan it or not to pay it? You decide not to pay it, what you're going to be? How you want Allah to accept it, all your ibadah? And doing that to serve himself Allah. It's just something simple. So Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, حَدَّثَ إِذَا غَرِيمَ حَدَّثَ فَكَذَبَ. He tells lies. وَذَا وَعَدْ أَخْلَفَ. If he promised, he breaks his promise. So be free of debt in your life. حديث 251. وعن أبي بكر الصديق رضي الله عنه أنه قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم علمني دعاء. Go to one of the imams, say علمني دعاء, teach me دعاء, teach me سورة. Teach me dua, teach me surah. Yes. If you know the person knows more than you, you'll ask. Ask. There was old man, Arabi. He came to the Imam one day. He said to the Imam, "Oh Imam, teach me one dua." Imam said, "Yeah." Say Subhanallah wa bihamdihi 100 times. No one is coming judgment day better than you. Start Subhanallah bihamdi, Subhanallah bihamdi, every morning, every maghrib, every evening. Yeah. And he fell sick. They took him to hospital. The doctor examined him. And doctor knows he's going to die now. No time left for him. So they pull the doctor and whisper on his ear. Doctor, listen carefully. Doctor, assuming he's given his will, last will. He said, "Yeah, doctor, say Subhanallah bihamdihi in the morning and evening." Still, he's giving ta'awud and last breath. Yeah. So you learn and you teach. Whenever you are with someone, that someone will be one of two. He's more knowledgeable than you, or he's less knowledge than you. If he's more knowledgeable than you, learn from him. Ask him questions. If he's less knowledgeable than you, teach him what he needs. But teach him what he needs on that. That's how the life is. No waste. Go with friends, and you say, "Oh, you are killing. You are killing, and then you are firing on hellfire tomorrow. That killing will be fire on judgment day. So don't waste your time. Time is counted. Alimni du'an ad'u bihi fi salati. Teach me du'a I use in my salah." Qala qul. You should say. Allahumma inni zalamtu nafsi dhulman kathira. Yeah. That's Abu Bakr. Yeah. He didn't do a lot of dhulm. What about compare Abu Bakr to us? We did more and more great severe dhulm on ourselves and on others. I still think we are right. Still we think we are right. Yeah. So, oh Allah, yeah. I've done to myself, my life, yeah, a lot of wrong. But I have no one forgives the sins except you. واغفر لي مغفرة من عندك وارحمني. Allah forgive me. Yeah. And have mercy on me. إنك أنت الغفور الرحيم. You are the forgiving and merciful one. This is one of the normal du'as you can recite. So now let's put in order. التحيات السلام أشهد الصلاة على النبي. And then من عذاب القبر من عذاب النار. That's five. Put on five on side. First four for first attahiyat, and five of them in the last attahiyat. Always that on the table. There is one dua we should recite when you are before Tasleem. Yes. So that six du'as. So dua number five and dua number six in between. There is another 11 to us. You can recite as much as you like. You understand this lecture? The du'as in the last tashahhud, we start with Allah min a'udhu bika min a'dhabi jahannam. Oh, that's number one. For the du'as, last tashahhud, Allah min a'udhu bika min a'dhabi jahannam. And the last one, yeah, we'll see inshallah. In between, it depends on you. You bring your own sunnah, you bring your own tahajjud, read a lot of du'as. So you want to learn a lot of du'as in that stage. So this Allah min idram bi nafsi is one of the normal du'as in between you can recite. The last point of the salah, at-tasleem. At-tasleem means assalamu alaykum. So that assalamu alaykum, going to take in details inshallah. Or in hurry, going to take in details. Maybe you don't see any lesson about tasleem in your life, so I want to focus on this. And while bin Hujr, we talked about his biography before, we mentioned it. He was one of the children of a royal family in Yemen. Yes. Okay, he came to visit the Prophet accept Islam, and then he came in the last years of the Prophet. Yeah. They say when he came to Prophet, the Prophet was a bit old and built weight. So when he have seen the way the Prophet praying and he mentioned it, some of the scholars they didn't take his view. They said, because the Prophet was very old the time he have seen. It doesn't mean always you pray there. There's a lot of argument we'll see inshallah when it comes later on about Wa'il bin Hujr. He said he prayed Salat Ma'anawi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So when he came and have seen the Prophet, he watched the Prophet carefully, the way the Prophet was praying. Very accurately. فَقَانُوا يُسَلُّمُ عَنْ يَمِينِهِ. He says salam to his right side. As-salamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Full version. وَعَنْ شِمَالِهِ. And he turned his left and he says as-salamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. رواه أبو داود بسنة صحيح. There is different versions of تسليم. السلام عليكم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. So we want to see what's the difference and how you can use and when we can use in this lesson and next lesson inshallah. First of all, تسليم is ركن. Pillar. We mention it in the salah. In the salah, there is something called shurut, preconditions. What required from you before salah? Like Islam, if kafir comes and he wants to pray, his salah is not acceptable. So you have to be Muslim. That's one of the conditions. You have to have wudu or tayammum. That's one of the conditions. So conditions is what required from you before you start your salah. And then al-arkan, pillars. And then al-wajibat. And then as-sunan. And then al-makruhat. And then al-mubdilat. So you want to learn that six if you want your salah to be accurate. Your salah to be accurate, you learn that six. So now, tasleem is one of the arkan. Tasleem is one of the arkan. If you pray your salah, and at the last, if you forget to say salam alaikum and you walk, you'll be that salah. That's valid. So rukniya to tasleem, going to prove tasleem is rukn, one of the arkan. Sahih Abi Dawood an Ali radiallahu anhu qal Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam miftahu salat, the key to open your salah, to start your salah is purification. If you don't have purification, that means you can't pray your salah. وَتَحْرِيمُهَا تَحْرِيم means it is making haram what was allowed for you. For example, allowed for you to talk. allow for you to eat. We say, Allahu Akbar, all that's going to be haram. So it makes haram for something was allowed for you to do before. Takbirat al-haram. That's why I said takbirat al-haram. You can't say Allahu Akbar and you walk the way you like. You can't say Allahu Akbar at the beginning of the salah and you talk to someone. You can't say Allahu Akbar and then you eat your food. All that's allowed to halal, but when it comes to Allahu Akbar, it makes all that haram to you. وَتَحْلِيلُهَا التَّسْلِيمُ And then salam makes halal what has been haram for you by takbir. So that's the boundary. Takbir to ihram to taslim. Now we understand what it means to takbir to ihram. وَتَحْلِيلُهَا It makes allow it for you what was prohibited by takbir to ihram. By Tasleem. Can you feel the Tasleem? How you should say Tasleem? The way we should implement it. We stop here, inshallah. Subhanak Allahumma bihamdika ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Wa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ala nabiyyina wa ala alihi wa sahbihi. Wa man tabi'ahum bi ihsanin ila yawmiddin.